Yaskawa.
You're watching the IEC 61131 Basics series. This is Programming Quick Start Part 2. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier, and in this segment, we will build on the example from the previous video by creating our own task, instance, start some simple structured text programming, and work more closely with variable usage and data types. Building on our example application of a parking gate control, we had a counter, and we're counting the number of cars that come through the parking lot with a sensor. And maybe this is our business. We want to make some money. We'd like to be able to calculate how much money should be coming in. While you could do this in any of the languages, let's do it using a structured text program. This is a perfect example of when structured text lends itself well to programming over function block. And in our template, we do not yet have any structured text program. So let's go through the process of creating a new structured text program. You'll right click on the logical POUs, insert the program, and let's demonstrate that here. Okay, so with the resource window closed and debug off, we'll go to the logical POUs in the project tree and right click insert program, type in the name. In this case, I'm going to call it money, and you choose the language, ST for structured text. Click OK, and it gives you the structured text code. Notice there's even a slightly different color and look to the pieces of the POU here. However, I ask you, is this POU, does it exist in the PLC by creating it here? If you look over to the PLC, which is the resource, you can see that it's not in one of the tasks. And so this is the second step anytime you insert a POU, a program POU, is a program POU runs in a task, and so you'll have to insert it manually into one of the tasks, or if not, create a new task. In this example, we will add it to the existing task by right-clicking Insert Program Instance. So let me demonstrate that. The POU's name is Money. Right-click Insert Program Instance into this task. I'm going to call it Money. Now, don't stop here. How many times have I seen people type in the name and click OK? That's not right. You have to choose the program type. All of the existing logical POUs for the project will be listed here in alphabetical order. And so you need to choose the title and the type of program. We typically make those match. So there it is, money, money. The name's in there twice because one of them we typed in, the other one's the program type. So now the logical POU called money is running in the cyclic task. This separation of the logical POUs and the physical hardware is an important concept in IEC 61131, and the reason for it is to allow modularity and reusability of the parts of the program between one hardware platform and another. However, if we open up money, you'll see that it's completely blank because we have not programmed it yet. So programming in the structured text language involves much use of the F5 key, because the F5 key is used to declare variables and put those variables into the variable list of the POU. It's really important to use F5 and not just type in the word that you want for the variable. So let's go through it here. We'll hit F5, choose income. You can refer to this page of the training guide. It'll be, we'll use data type LReal in this case so that we can handle decimal places. Real or LReal would work. We'll use LReal. We have income colon equals number of cars times LReal pound 29.99. This is the format for the literal data, a constant. Okay, so let's do it. We'll type F5. My variable is called income. With the data type, I'll tab over to data type here, LReal. I'll stick with usage var for now. Income, and the syntax here is colon equal. That means set the data equal to. Now I'll hit a space here and F5 again. If you don't hit the space, it may automatically just select some text. So I usually hit a space. And number of cars, stick with LReal again, and then times, all caps, LReal, You may not need all caps, but that's what I do. Pound. And let's say we're in Chicago here. We charge $29.99 to park. Good deal. And you terminate every line with a semicolon. As a quick check here, if you look at money V, the variable list, you better see income and number of cars. If you don't see it there, maybe it's because you didn't type F5 when you declared the variable. Very common mistake. So once you have this typed in, you can go to download changes again. And let's go to debug mode and see if it worked. Right now I have zero income. You can always hover over these here to see what the variable data is. Number of cars there is zero. So let's go back to main and let's trip the sensor a few times here. Now what's going on? You know what? We're using the variable here called current value. I think we need to make an update now to call it number of cars. So let's do that. Call it number of cars. Download changes. And if you guys who know IEC might notice that there's a mistake going on here, but I'm going to be using this mistake to prove and teach a point. Okay, so now we got number of cars, 2, 3. All right, I should be making tons of money over in the money POU. Wait a minute, it still says zero. I've got number of cars here says zero. Number of cars here says 3. So what could be going on? And what's going on here is that number of cars is not the same value in both POUs because it's not the same variable. If you look at the variable list, you'll see that number of cars in the main POU is an integer data type, and that number of cars is an LREL, and it's just a completely separate variable. Each local variable list has its own variable, and then you can reuse the names of variables between the different POUs. So what we need to do is to connect the two POUs to be able to share the data in this variable by using a global variable. And one convention that we have is to make that very clear by putting a G underscore in the name. It's a naming convention for variables. And then you choose var global when you create the variable. And that confirms the fact that you're using a global variable. So global variable allows data to be passed between different POUs. So let's implement this. I'll change my counter from number of cars, and I'll put in a new variable called G underscore number of cars. And then let's also update the text number of cars. And one thing you can do is hit F5 here, number of cars, change it to, again, G underscore number of cars. This is a okay, so now we have, if you look at the variable list, we got G number of cars, and main has G underscore number of cars, and you may even look at the global variable list, haven't showed this yet, but let's look at it. Global variables also has G number of cars. So this is where the data is truly stored, is in this global variable list. So now let's download changes. All right, and now with this global variable, let's look at debug mode. My number of cars here are at 3. And G number of cars is still 0. So why is this? And I think I know what I did wrong here. I did an additional thing wrong, is I did not do what I said I would do. I chose G number of cars, and I gave it the name G for global, but I did not change the usage itself to global. So let's go back and do that. Change the usage to global. Let's be sure that both main is global and money variable is global. Global will come up as var external. Explain more about that. and then later on, but let's just go with it for now. So I have them both now as global, and now I have an error. Got an error. It says error 2 warnings. And go to this error tab. It says here, no matching global variable found for money, G number of cars, and missing resource. So you double click on that, it highlights the area of problem. It says it can't find a G number of cars L real in the resource. Well, here's the physical hardware resource. It's the global variable list. Can't find a matching variable. Well, there it is. Doesn't it match? G number of cars. Oh, int. So it's an integer in global variables. In the main variable list, G number of cars is an integer. But in money, G number of cars is an L real. So this is where data type is very important in the IEC world. This is going to be true for any of the programming interfaces that you use, is you have to have agreement of data types, and data type is very important. When you do mathematical operations on data, they have to be of the same data type only. And so if you don't have the same data type, you'll have to convert it. There is no automatic conversion. In some senses, it would be nice to think, oh, well, I know that a 3 is the same as a 3.0. Well, in IEC, it is not. IEC 6731 says the data types must be the same and there will be no assumptions made. The assumptions must be part of the program, and that's considered a best programming practice. And so we will have to do that here ourselves and convert that over. So I will keep G number of cars as an integer. And then in the money POU, we will not use directly that integer called G number of cars. Instead, let's create, we'll use the variable we had before called number of cars. So F5, number of cars, that's an L real, colon equals. And now we need to convert G number of cars from an integer to an L real. So let's get the conversion from the edit wizard. There's a function for converting called type convert functions. And we want to convert int to L real. I'll type I here, int to L real. Int to L real. Okay, they're giving us part of what we already have. The result as an L real is number of cars. And now what is the input as an integer? The input as an integer is the G underscore. Oh, I better use F5 here. Make some space here and hit F5. G number of cars, that's the integer. Okay, and then for the code, we will not use G number of cars. We'll use, hit F5 again here, number of cars, which is L real. So now we have an L real times an L real because we first converted one to the other. So let's try that download changes and see if that works. It says there's been an error and that download changes has been aborted. Let's click OK. It says see PLC errors. There's an error. Whenever you see an error flashing in the PLC, you need to click on it. It says error instruction not implemented or error exceeded at data type. It doesn't like this line. And for whatever reason, there's a little trick you have to do. I believe this is a minor issue with the PLC simulator. And the fix here is to go into the simulator by right-clicking the resource and its settings and just point this to simulation number 2 and click OK. And I believe that will fix this issue. Let's do will download changes work for simulation 2. So we will do a full download here. And it says warm start is not possible. Let's do a cold start. We could even stop it and do a warm start. And I think now we'll be good. Okay, so that one more time was you right-click on the resource, look at settings, and choose simulation 2. And that seems to fix the issue. There's nothing wrong with this code. This is exactly how you do a conversion of integer to L real. So now in debug mode, let's see what we've got. go back into the main POU, and let's have a couple of cars go in there. I'll click on the sensor. Let's open ourselves up for business here. And we've got three cars. Let's go into the money POU. There's the calculation. Everything seems to be working. We got three cars. Three converts to 3.0 through this line, and our income is multiplied, and we have $89.97. So this is as far as we'll take it. We created a new POU called money. We put that in the task as an instance. We used a global variable to convert it into a local variable with a different data type, the LReal data type. And we made a calculation based on that data from the main POU. So with this, we will conclude programming quick start number 2, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.